So I can just share a few. I will not talk about all of them. The report has many more and they are comprehensive. We think IEBC should train all elections officials from ROs, PROs, POs and DPOs, as well as the clerks in good time, to avoid a situation where staff are trained and are not engaged because of nepotism and considerations other than competence. We know that in Mombasa, IEBC trained 500 clerks, but then they gave ROs and POs the mandate to employ. Instead of them employing from the 500 trained, they all started giving jobs to their relatives who had no training. And that's the confusion that was witnessed. So we have this on authority of staff who are working there, and these are issues that we need to deal with. We also think IEBC should be well-resourced, sufficiently staffed to ensure effective delivery of its services, given the enormous weight of the task that now encompasses queue management, use of technology for tallying and voter identification, and long hours necessary to conduct 6 elections in one day. I mean, the tragedy is that we do 6 elections in a day. And so we can't take it lightly that staff who are not well prepared and who are not sufficient in numbers can do this and pull it off effectively. We also think the national elections are often organized and conducted under immense political pressure without sufficient planning into the process. So the pre-electoral cycle requires some thinking, and it's critical that the electoral body learns from the things that it has seen, the challenges that it has faced in 3 disputed elections. We can't have an electoral body that has not done 3 elections properly, purporting to